Thank you, Walter. Hopefully everybody understands the importance of the relationship that we have with Microsoft. As we position the brand to be an innovator in technology, this partnership will truly help us to be able to do that. Okay, to wrap things up, I'm going to take you quickly through kind of where we're at from a marketing standpoint, and then we'll have the Q&A afterward. But when we were preparing this pitch, we were looking back over the last 18 months and realizing from a marketing standpoint what a dream it's been to be able to launch the all-new Soul, the Forte, the Coupe, and the Sorento, and now to be able to launch this vehicle as well within 18 months. That says a lot. And this vehicle, as Steve mentioned, has over 200,000 units in operation. So we're taking a little bit different approach than we did in the past. Whereas Soul, we were laying the foundation, we were building kind of the that vehicle as a halo vehicle for the brand. The Forte, all new nameplate, required a lot of heavy lifting to get that nameplate launched. Sorento introduced the new plant, but also kind of showing the American consumer that kind of Kia is a brand to take more seriously, so a lot of heavy lifting there. Sportage, we're going to take a little different approach. As you can see here, we're really going to focus on the right target for Sportage to kind of help maintain that momentum. You know, the Soul, as I mentioned, was positioned to attract younger buyers, the Forte to attract more buyers based on style, but not just on value, and then the Coupe to attract more buyers. So a lot of momentum built from these three vehicles that we're going to continue on here. Steve mentioned some consumer research. We do research, both product research and positioning research, throughout the development process. In one of the latest clinics that we conducted with some of the competitors in the segment, brought consumers in, showed them the vehicles. They were the badges were hidden. We didn't really talk about them, and we asked them what were their choices. 32% of the consumers told us that the all-new Sportage was their first choice. And this was consistent with what we saw on Forte and Sorento as well. So very excited to see the appeal for this vehicle. Then, what we do traditionally is we take them through the interior and the exterior, we take them through the specifications and the pricing, and then we reveal the brand. And in this case, like we have seen in the past, we did see some consumers drop off once we revealed the brand. So we showed them, okay, this is a Kia. And it dropped from 32% to 28% in terms of their first choice. What that tells us is that there still is that perception out there amongst consumers of kind of the Kia of old, but we believe we are making significant progress in changing the perception of our brand. So we felt very good about this information. What we found is that over 50% of the consumers told us that they would probably or definitely consider the Sportage in their next purchase consideration. And of that, 54% of them were males, which we had not seen in the past. The design was very appealing to the male consumers that we had brought in, very polarizing for the females. So thought that was interesting. Interior, saw about the same. Both males and females liked the interior. So that helped us in terms of the target customer. And we had some assumptions that we had made going into this process. This just confirmed who we were going after. So we are targeting a younger single or single-minded male looking to move into a stylish vehicle that really fits kind of a new stage of life for them. And what we mean by this is we call it adulthood 2.0. It's a bit of a mindset that they're in. As you can see here, we've got the Soul customer, the Soul mindset that consumer is in the target of we as a group. The Sorento is in that mindset of we as a family. And the Sportage mindset is really about me. So I've kind of moved on from my friends. I've realized that my job isn't just a job, but it's an opportunity for a career. I'm taking things a little more serious in life. I'm not looking for a vehicle necessarily just to go camping or off-roading, which the vehicle can do, but I'm really looking for a vehicle that's going to help me navigate the roads that lie ahead of me as I pursue this new journey. So that's kind of the mindset that we're positioning this vehicle in. It's, again, adulthood 2.0. And it fits nicely within the media targets that we had for the Soul and for the Sorento. As you can see, the Soul media target was age 18 to 34, with really most of the emphasis on the 18 to 24-year-old. And then on the other end of the spectrum, the Sorento was positioned, the media target 25 to 49, but more of an emphasis on the 34 to 49-year-old. So the Sportage now is wedged kind of right there in the middle, again, from age perspective, 25 to 49, but most of the emphasis on that 25 to 34-year-old male single college grad. So this is, we've got a 30-second spot that is still kind of, we're in post-production right now, but just wanted to give you an idea of what we're going to put on broadcast beginning in August. Again, it's really to speak to the target customer. They're in a different mindset than, say, the Soul customer or the Sorento. Really wanted to show the vehicle its flexibility, its versatility, and show how this vehicle will enable that target customer to move forward in life. Music, very important to us as a brand and also very important to the target customer. So very cool, modern music track to go along with it. I know everybody was probably expecting a hamster to jump out at the end, but there are no hamsters in this campaign. Again, taking a little bit more of a serious approach to this target customer as they take a more serious approach in their lives as well. Traditionally, we have 360-degree integration with our campaigns, continuing that with the Sportage. Broadcast will be a good component of it, but actually, as I mentioned, we've got 200,000 units in operation already, so we're going to do a lot of time and effort talking to those owners and talking to them in a language talking to them about the features and attributes that are important to them. And also digital will play a heavy component in this launch as well, again, because the target customer spends a lot of time in that space. So that kind of sums it up from a marketing standpoint of where we're at. From a brand standpoint, as we mentioned, back in March 2009, we launched the Soul, quickly followed by the Forte, then the Forte Coupe. Earlier this year, the launch of the all-new Sorento. You are here participating in the launch of the all-new Sportage. Later in August, we'll come out with a higher trim version of the new Sorento called the Sorento SX. And then in September, we come out with a Forte derivative, the Forte 5-door. Later this year, we come out with the Optima. And then there's even more news next year. So we'd like to say that we've really taken on, we're the industry's most aggressive in terms of introducing new products to the marketplace in an economy that, as Tom mentioned, has been a little rocky. But we didn't stop. We keep going forward, and we hope the momentum is going to continue to push us forward as well.